हेलो माय मोस्ट एडोरेबल जीनियस स्टूडेंट्स, गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स। लेट्स स्टार्ट रीडिंग द नेक्स्ट पार्ट ऑफ दिस फर्स्ट पैसेज। इन दिस फर्स्ट पार्ट, ओके, लुइस कैरोल द क्रिएटर ऑफ एलिस इन वंडरलैंड वाज सेड टू हैव हैड जस्ट हॉरर ऑफ द इंटरव्यूअर। लुइस कैरोल द क्रिएटर ऑफ एलिस इन वंडरलैंड। Alice in Wonderland is a fictitious, unreal, self-invented story for children, and the creator, the writer of this story, unreal story, fictitious story, is Lewis Carroll. So once Lewis Carroll was also interviewed. So when he was interviewed, he got some new experiences in his life. So it is reported that he was said to have had a just horror of the interviewer. Oh, when Lewis Carroll sat before the interviewer, he got himself badly afraid of the person. He found himself in a very big terror-like situation. And he never consented. The word consented means agreed. He never got agreed himself to be interviewed. No. Lewis Carroll did not get himself agreed to the term interview, and he rejected the idea of being interviewed. He quite frankly denied it, saying that he would not like to be interviewed because he did not want to show his reality to others. What was the main cause of declining the offer for being interviewed? So the cause is mentioned here. Was his horror? I'm sorry. It was his horror of being lionized. Lionized. The word lionized stands for beta, treat as a celebrity. So here, being, after being, we put a third form. So being treated as a celebrity. So lionized stands for here. Lionized stands for here. Treated as a celebrity. So it was his horror of being treated as a celebrity. He did not want to give permission to anyone to treat him as a celebrity. He did not want to get himself interviewed as a celebrity, which made him thus repel. Repel stands for air, move away, move back. Okay? Which made him thus repel. When he got himself badly frightened of an idea of being a celebrity in any one's studio or at any other place, he found himself at the back foot. He did not want to go forward, which made him thus repel. Repel stands for here, move away. That's why he did not face the interview, thinking that if he was interviewed, he would be famous, his identity would be represented, displayed, okay, before his acquaintances, interviewers, and the persistent petitioners for his autograph. He thought that once he was interviewed, Lewis Carroll thought that if he was interviewed, his true identity would be reflected, okay, before his old acquaintances, familiar ones, before the interviewers, all the interviewers, okay, working in different parts of the country, of the world, and his persistent petitioners also. Okay? And they would like to get his autograph. They would come to him to get his autograph. And he would afterwards relate the stories of his success in silencing all such people with much satisfaction and amusement. And when he would find a big crowd of the people, and when he would see a big crowd, a huge crowd, a big crowd of the people standing all around him in order to get his autograph, his signature, and to ask many more about his success, that's why he did not want to get himself interviewed. Okay, bete. Rudyard Kipling expressed an even more condemnatory stance for her strongly disapproval feelings. Okay, strongly disapproval attitude. Rudyard Kipling expressed an even more condemnatory attitude towards the interviewer. So this statement tells us that when Rudyard Kipling was interviewed, he did not take that the interview wholeheartedly. He did not like the interviewer also. He created a sense of haterness in his mind towards the interviewer. That's why his attitude towards that interviewer was totally, okay, aggressive, was totally against his normal feelings. So even more condemnatory attitude stands for a disapproval attitude, okay, rejected attitude. So he did not want to. Rudyard Kipling also disliked the term the interview. He did not like it. His wife Caroline writes in her diary for 14 October 1892. Rudyard Kipling's wife Caroline also writes in her diary dated 14th October 1892 that their day was wrecked by two reporters from Boston. The word wrecked stands for here completely destroyed. Caroline wrote in her diary on 14th October 1892 stating it out that day on 14th of October, means 14th October, the day of 14th October had been completely destroyed by two reporters who had come from Boston to conduct the interview of Rudyard Kipling and his wife Caroline. She reports her husband as saying to the reporters, okay, while saying something to the reporters, she also reported her husband, okay, why do I refuse to be interviewed? She also reported her husband as saying to the reporters, and she asked, first of all, she told her husband, okay, something about the two reporters who had come from Boston to conduct an interview of both the husband and wife, Rudyard Kipling and his wife, Caroline. Then she asked her husband to get his opinion why she refused to be interviewed. She asked her husband if he knew why she refused to be interviewed. Since she did not want to be interviewed, okay, by any reporter, but her husband Rudyard Kipling would have permitted her, saying that she should get herself ready for interview, and she had to undergo the interview, and that the interview, okay, tortured and hurt the feelings of Caroline a lot, and she got highly aggressive, she got highly agitated, because it is immoral. She told her husband that the interview had hurt her feelings a lot, and she took that the interview as an immoral task, and she called it immoral. Okay, Caroline called it immoral job. It is a crime. She also called it a crime, just as much of a crime as an offense against any person. She told her husband and she told her husband saying that the interview had proved just like a big crime of big offense, okay, an immoral task for her inner life, and she did not like it on her part, just as much of a crime as an offense against my person, as an assault. She also told her husband that she had not permitted him to get himself interviewed by those two reporters, but he did not care for her words, and that's why he found himself badly hurt by those the reporters, and that the day, proved a very wrecked day, very insulting day, a very unfortunate day, just like a doomed day for him in his life. As an assault stands for attack. Okay, just as much of a crime as offense against my person as an assault, and just as much merits punishment. Okay, so through this statement we conclude that Rudyard Kipling's wife did not like the term interview. She expressed her anger, she expressed her disapproval, saying it that a person should never get himself or herself interviewed, because interviewing, that the task of interviewing was just like an immoral task, immoral job. Okay, it was just like a big crime, and it was not less than a big attack on the soul, on the mind, on the heart of the interviewee. That's why she also expressed her sorrowful feelings, while telling something to her husband, that if he had got agreed to her words, so he would not have faced so much problem on that specific day when he was interviewed by two reporters who had come from Boston. It is cowardly and vile. Vile stands for very bad, very unpleasant, very bad, very shocking. It is cowardly and vile. The interview was also regarded as a very disgusting task, dangerous task, and cowardly act. A person who is chicken-hearted person is called coward person, is called coward. So it is cowardly and vile. She also called it a cowardly and vile task, very dirty task, very dangerous task. No respectable man would ask it. She commented that not a single one respectable person would like to get himself interviewed, much less give it. It means he or she, that the person would never like to give any kind of importance to interview, and if he was interviewed, he would get less and lose more in his life. Yet Kipling had himself perpetrated. Kipling get himself perpetrated. Such an assault on Mark Twain only a few years before. H.G. Wells, in an interview in 1894, referred to the interviewing ordeal. Yet Kipling had himself perpetrated as an assault on Mark Twain only a few years before, when Rudyard Kipling was interviewed, he also called it as an assault, as a very big attack. Assault stands for attack. As a very big attack on his soul, on his heart, on his feelings. H.G. Wells, in an interview in 1894, referred to the interviewing Odin. The word Odin stands for here a very unpleasant okay experience. So when H.G. Wells was interviewed, so he also considered it as a very unpleasant experience. He did not like it, but was a fairly frequent interviewee. Though once he had declared it, okay, as a very unpleasant experience of life, but thereafter H.G. Wells was such a person who was frequently interviewed, who became as a frequent interviewee, and 40 years later found himself interviewing Joseph Stalin. And after a long span of 40 years, he also found himself in such a position to hold an interview, to take an interview of a well-known Joseph Stalin stands for here. Joseph Stalin is a great Russian revolutionary and active political organizer. So he also took the interview, held the interview of such kind of great personality, Russian personality, Joseph Stalin. Okay. Firstly, he had got himself badly afraid of that the term interview, H.G. Wells, but later, after 40 years, he also conducted the interview of Joseph Stalin. Saul Bellow, who has also agreed to be interviewed on several occasions. Nevertheless, the word nevertheless stands for beta, in spite of that. खैर जो कुछ भी उसके बावजूद हिंदी में इसका अर्थ निकाला जाता है. Who has consented to be interviewed on several occasions, nevertheless once described interviews. Though Saul Bellow had kept himself under so many interviews, had got himself interviewed frequently, had faced so many interviews in his life, thereafter he described interviews as being like thumbprints on his windpipe. It's a phrase, beta. Thumbprints on his windpipe, it stands for a suffocated, choked. He found himself fully suffocated, okay, by the pressure of the interviewee. He found himself fully suffocated. A person who finds himself fully suffocated by the unnecessarily pressure, okay, of somebody on his throat, on his mind, could be described as the term thumbprints on windpipe. So उसको भी इस प्रकार से बहुत ज्यादा घुटन सी महसूस हुई बाद में. हालांकि वो बार बार अपना साक्षात्कार कराता रहा था, लेकिन उसके बावजूद भी उसको बहुत ज्यादा इस तरह से काफी तकलीफ से सहन करनी पड़ी. उसने बाद में साक्षात्कारों को उसने कहा कि भाई ये तो वास्तव में बड़े परेशानी उत्पन्न करने वाले, घुटन उत्पन्न करने वाले और एक इस प्रकार का एक साधन है. येट डेस्पाइट द ड्रॉबैक्स ऑफ द इंटरव्यू, डेस्पाइट में इन स्पाइट ऑफ बेटा. However, here are so many celebrities who have declared the interview as a very terrific thing, and they have described here so many drawbacks, so many disadvantages of the term interview. Yet, despite the drawbacks of the interview, means yes, in spite of so many drawbacks, so many disadvantages of the term interview, it is a supremely stands for extremely serviceable medium of communication. This the interview has become one of the most important means of communication nowadays everywhere in the world. These days, more than at any other time, our most vivid impressions of our contemporaries. The word contemporary stands for a better person of the same age or the same time, generation we call it. Okay, these days more than at any other time, our most vivid impressions of our contemporaries are through contemporaries, means persons of the same age, of the same time, interviews. Though at the same time, this the interview has also got the impressions of different kinds of persons' lives okay, through interviews. Through interviews, the lifestyle and the personality and the expressions and the feelings of so many persons, thousands of persons, have been taken by the interviewers, okay, by the interviewers, and it has become once again an important part of a person's life. These days, more than at any other time, our most vivid impressions of our contemporaries are through interviews. It means, okay, the persons of the same age, of the same time, of the same category, okay, are also interviewed, and they let their impressions on others through the interviews. Okay, almost everything of moment reaches us through one man asking questions. When a person asks questions to the other one, okay, so each and everything is displayed, each and everything is unveiled, is disclosed by that person. Okay, when the interviewer asks a question to the interviewee, so he responds the question, and he tells something about his life very clearly. Okay, because of this, the interviewer holds a position of unprecedented power and influence. That's why the position of the interviewer becomes at top class, and his position, nobody can predict about the mind of the interviewer, what he will ask and what kinds of question he or she will give to the interviewee. So that's why the position of the interviewer, okay, remains very important, with so much power and influence. The interviewer always has so much influence on the minds of the interviewee, and he holds a very good position in his life. Okay, thank you. Now you have to revise the first part as we have read it very thoroughly, so that whenever the turn of this chapter comes, okay, for an examination, you can write down the answer to all questions. I would also provide the answer to all textual questions, okay, within a day or two. Okay, till then, keep yourself fully connected to your syllabus, and also get yourself fully prepared for the upcoming test, unit test, June 2020, with learning all questions answers, okay, of the chapters which have been included in the syllabus. This time you all must take the examination, okay, surely, mandatorily, urgently. Okay, there should be no column to remain absent. Thank you very much.